Welcome to the very first video of World of Warcraft Classic Hardcore. We're going to create a brand new character over here. And I think this time we're going to play Hunter. And I think if we play Hunter, it has to be a dwarf, right? There can't be a human. There can't be a gnome. Night Elves, I feel like they only have dodge chance, which is good for leveling to 10. But when you play a dwarf, you actually get increased gun damage, so, or skill with guns. That just means you'll crit more often, and it will most probably be stronger once you get this character up there. So we're going to play Hunter, randomize a few times. I don't know about the female, though. Female dwarf looks so weird. Let's call this Master YouTube. Perfect. The name is unavailable. Something like that. All right, to the gun. If you do enjoy, leave a like, subscribe if you're new, and let's do this.
Heroic dwarves of Ironforge spent countless generations mining treasures from deep within the earth. Hidden within their impregnable stronghold of Ironforge Mountain, they rarely ventured beyond the wintry peaks of Dulmora. Recently, however, the dwarves unearthed a series of ruins that held secrets to their ancient heritage. Driven to discover the truth about his people's fabled origins, the great king, Magni Bronzebeard, ordered that the dwarves shift their industry from mining to archaeology. As part of the Grand Alliance, the stalwart dwarven armies have been called away to battle the merciless horde in faraway lands. In these perilous times, the defense of the Mountain Kingdom falls to brave dwarves like you. The spirits of the ancient kings watch over you, and the very mountains are your strength. The future of your people is in your hands.
It can't be. Alrighty then, let's do this.
Ah, well, aren't you a sturdy looking one? Perhaps you can assist me with a thing or two. Not much help around here except for green apprentices, and they've other things to worry about. What do we have here? You look as though you might need something to keep your hands warm, HM. I'll tell you what would help. A pair of nice warm gloves. And being the kind soul that I am, I'd be more than happy to provide you with a suitable pair. I've one condition, however. I need you to go get me some wolf meat. Nice arrangement, HM. You bring me some wolf meat, and I'll make sure you don't lose any digits to frostbite. Well, what do you say?
Sounds good. Let me just drag this macro to here, and then we want a random shoot one. This one. There we go, macros is done for now. So at level 10 we can actually get our pet, so up until then we're gonna be super weak, if you like. Hunters is most probably the weakest class until level 10, and then they instantly become the strongest class in the game. Let's see here. We also need to track our ammo. So, serpent sting we get at level 4. Thank you. Aspect of the Monkey we get at level 4 also. Which will make us dodge a little bit. Level 2, 500 XP grind. We have 177 bullets left. Stop dodging, accept my axe in your face. Good news. Didn't mean to attack the boar. But it's hide. So the pet to have, I'm not too sure what we'll get though, most probably a boar. Boars are somewhat tanky. It doesn't do the highest damage, but it can take a punch. And also the charge ability is extremely beautiful. It's a gap closer and it can keep the enemy away from you. Because you can't shoot if it's too close in Classic. On Retail, you can shoot whenever you want. Whether something is standing up against you or not, it doesn't matter. Okay, 500 XP, right? We're not there yet. Two more kills, I guess. How dare you miss? What the heck? Okay, now we should have more than enough. 550. So Aspect of the Monkey is going to be definitely needed, and Serpent Sting.
What's on your...
Ah, wonderful. The wolf meat should do nicely. Oh, don't worry, adventurer. I wouldn't forget my part of the bargain. Here, one of these should fit you. I don't suppose you'd be willing to do a favor for me, lass? A stack of letters came through the pass today, but I don't have the time to send them along. They're all addressed to Talyn Kenai. You can find him to the west down the road. He's set up camp next to the frozen lake. What do you say? While you were helping me out, this rune was given to me to pass on to you. Take some time to read it when you have a chance. I'm thinking it came from the hunter trainer Thorgus. Take a gander at it and go find him inside Anvilmar when you've a chance. I hope you're here to lend us a hand, adventurer. After the last Trog attack, we could use all the help we can get. I hear the buggers have been popping up all across the lands, and it seems Coldridge Valley is no exception. They've been spotted all over the hills to the southeast and near the frozen lake. And that's not all. Just a few nights ago, they attacked and overran our camp to the west. We're a bit short-handed here, lass, and we need strong arms to help drive the Trogs back.
Shoot it like it's hard. Ooh, nice crit we got there. 22? Pretty good stuff. And we reached level 3. Feels like it's so fast. Okay, one of them are done. Doesn't matter, the second one still needs to be done. Played 2 hours on our warlock and we never got a bag, by the way. We played 11 minutes on this character and we already have one. Goodness, where is the ones that we need to kill? They're just nowhere to be seen.
How are you?
Thank you. I've been waiting for these letters for quite some time. Unfortunately, these letters aren't all for me. This one is addressed to Grelin Whitebeard. He's not too far away if you'd like to deliver it to him. If I remember correctly, Grelin's camp is down the road to the southeast. No doubt he'll be eager to get his mail. Nothing like a day of boar hunting, eh? Though here in Coldridge Valley, there are so many boars it almost takes the fun out of it. No need to get them charging. They're all angry and ready without any help. In fact, recently, there have been so many boars in the area, it's become dangerous for me to do my daily hunting. Long story short, if you could help me kill some of the boars, I would appreciate it.
While active, grants immunity to bleed, poison, and disease effects. So got a new back. Kill it with fire. We have almost a 9% dodge chance. I don't know where these dudes are. It seems so rare.
Ah, excellent. It's been a while since I received word from Ironforge. My brother, Sunir, and I were sent to different parts of Don Morok to investigate the threat posed by the trolls. The Senate has its hands full with the Trogs, so they've no need for further annoyances. From what I've seen, the trolls aren't well situated here in Coldridge Valley, mostly the Southern Cave. I'd say that the army will not be necessary. A few strong arms should be more than enough. Perhaps you'd like to assist in this endeavor? I have the authority to offer compensation for your help.
Gah! I was supposed to get this delicious scalding morn brew to Dern and Furcutter inside Anvilmar a while ago now, but I had to deliver one to Grelin here first. I'll never make it to Anvilmar before the brew runs cold! You look fast. Maybe you can make it. This cup will only stay hot for 5 more minutes, and Dernan didn't order chili morn brew, so get going. Anvilmar is to the northeast, a settlement dug into the mountain. Thanks, adventurer, and don't forget to bring me back my mug.
I think we're gonna just drop everything and just go there right now. We are level 4. We can train on new stuff. We can get a little bit stronger. So we can get Aspect of the Monkey and Serpent Sting. Both is extremely useful. I think Aspect of the Monkey gives us like 4% increased dodge chance or something like that. Maybe even more. Maybe more. And then Serpent Sting is our overtime poison.
And we gnomes have been scattered all over Don Morok. In my haste to get away from the radiation, I lost all my personal belongings and tools. It was the trolls that got me. They stole my chest, my box, and my bucket of bolts. They took them back to their camp southwest of Anvilmar. I'm no adventurer. Could you find my things and bring them here to me, please?
One thing you should always remember is that you've got to respect the world you're living in. The beasts that choose to fight alongside you. The shine of your weapon, the weight of your ammo, the bite of a bitter wind, all these things you need to know intimately. I'll do what I can to help you, but most of the work's up to you. Anytime you think you're ready, come back and talk to me. I'll train you when I can.
Ah, good. Now this will hit the spot. Allow me to take a small break while I enjoy this scalding morn brew. Now that hit the spot. Nothing like a piping hot, nay, scalding morn brew on a cold winter's day to warm your cackles of your soul. Here you go, adventurer. Be a pal and take this empty mug back to Nori for me, would you now?
Look at that difference already. Just what poison makes. Okay, so let's see our aspect of the cheetah. Or Aspect of the Monkey. So it's a permanent buff that remains on you, but you always have to remember to use one. I do have a pretty cool macro for that as well.
Ah!
long as we get the serpent sting on them. Oh my goodness, bro. Just... would you please? Just fall over for me. Eh. We're gonna get attacked. There we go. The doggy wants to talk a lot, apparently. You're not gardener should be here, that's why. I just honestly don't understand. Like, our gardeners here, like, 3 times a week. I don't know why they're still, like, barking out of their minds when they see him. Because we got a new chess piece. Very good, very good. I shouldn't have sold all my food. Right. Okay, we only need one more, so we can start running out. Very good, very good. Got a new back there.
How odd? Excellent, adventurer! You'd be surprised how many couriers I meet who forget to do something as simple as bring back the mug. Mugs don't grow on trees, or so they tell me. Here's a little something for the effort. Thanks again for your help. Ah! Those light-blasted trolls! A group of them came in the night and stole my journal! Knew better than to trust that good-for-nothing APR. My journal! They took it away to the cave. The one that had it? It was a big brute with some odd markings on his skin and face. I didn't get a much better look than that. You've had some luck with the trolls. Maybe you could go get it back for me.
Hmm. So we're shooting at max distance, so we can only get like 3 bullets in before they get too close. What level are we now? Level 5. So deep inside the cave is where we need to go right now. Restore 61 health over 18 seconds. So we do have some food. Supposed to have better gun skill, and then you still miss like a little noob, huh? What the heck? What the heck? There we go. I want to see those crit numbers. Those boom headshot numbers. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Got a new belt. It's a cloth belt though. But it's extra armor nonetheless. Got a new panties. It's kind of a big upgrade. 15 armor difference. Coster, perfect. We need more casters, dude. This way they can take the full force of our gun. Oh. What's that? There was a healing? Stop it! I said stop it, bro. Stop running. Goodness. You might be hurting me. I want to get this loot. Okay, we didn't enter combat at least, so we're all still fine. Yeah. We have 189 bullets left, so we went through 200 bullets already. I don't see those headshots, dude. You're asking me, you're a useless hunter. It's headshot or the shot doesn't count, you know what I'm saying? Okay, sorry. I helped him with one to make up for it. Even though it wasn't my mistake, though. Didn't see each other. In the end, it doesn't even matter.
Many thanks for retrieving my notebook. Well, it would seem that the troll situation here in Coldridge Valley is under control and not much cause for worry. After I put the finishing touches on my report, I'll need someone to courier it to my brother, Senior. I was planning on sending my apprentice to my brother, Senior, with my report, but I would feel much better were it placed in more reliable hands. That is, of course, if you wouldn't mind. You'll have to take the tunnel to get to Karanos. Speak with Mountaineer Thalos before going through the tunnel. It's completely infested with trogs now. Follow the road back to Avilmar, then keep heading east to the tunnel. Thalos is stationed nearby.
Is that our first kill without them touching? Right, that's you. Don't touch me. Really? It tells me to run here to do this, and then it tells like, no, go back. Go back that way now. It even wanted us to use the Hearthstone.
If the problems we've had here are indicative of what is happening elsewhere in our lands, by Magni's beard, we have some troubles ahead of us. I can only hope that the King and Senate are taking steps to deal with the threat the Trogs pose.
Safe travels.
All righty then, so. Now we gotta grab some stuff here. We grab the small... No. Oh, we need to kill some more boars also. I don't see no boars. Yes, play those drums for me. Okay, I don't see more boars, bro. I guess there'll be more of them soon. Good crit, 18 there. I think it was with the axe, if I'm not mistaken. What I got. Found some boars, baby. Need to get two more. Job's done. They're ready to work. Righto. I mean, not that kind of orc. Work, work. Zog, zog.
Excellent, I can go back to my leisurely hunting now. Thank you, adventurer.
Another bag? Oh. So you're telling me we are full on bags? Now we can get one more. We can get one more. But I can't believe it, dude. The warlock didn't get a single bag in 2 hours. And we got two on this character. And by the way, my warrior, I think, has full bags. All 4 slots filled, and we didn't buy a single one. Isn't that crazy?
Hey! Huzzah! You found them! You're an absolute absolute savior, my friend. Here, it's not much, but it's something for the trouble I've put you through. Thank you.
I sell the finest cloth and leather garb this side of the valley.
Watch your back.
No, no, you watch yours, my friend.
What can I do for ye?
Oh, we got arcane shot and hunter's mark. Pretty good stuff.
See you soon.
Let us... Don't I have a macros for this? I do. This hunter's mark. Okay. So I guess this one will just be simple. We'll just drag arcane shot like this, and it's done. Okay, comedy we're actually done with the very first zone already. That's pretty good. And yes, I actually went to sleep. Well, not really sleep, but just like take a nap, even though it was 2.5 hour nap. It's pretty good stuff. Pretty good stuff. We should make our way to the path here. And the video is about 43 minutes, and we're level 6. I wonder if we'll be a higher level than with the Warlock. I mean, we had big issues with the Warlock, right?
What's on? Well, if Whitebeard is sending you to Dunmarok on important business, I can't very well stop you, can I? At least let me provide you with some advice and directions. The Trogs in the tunnel are extremely hostile and haven't shown any hesitation in attacking travelers through the tunnel. You seem tough enough, though, so you should probably be safe. Directions? If you're going to speak with Senir, you'll find him in Karanos. Make your way through the tunnel, and after you come out on the other side, just keep following the road. It'll run right into Karanos.
Hey! You look like a hardy adventurer. If you're planning on braving the pass, do you suppose you could bring a package to the inn in Karanos? You were planning on stopping at the inn, right? If you make it through the pass, you'll definitely want to take a breather there. Anyways, bring this to Tannic Frosthammer, the innkeeper's assistant. I can't get through the pass myself, and it'll be days until a mountaineer escort comes through.
There's a little bit much on the mana aspect. So we can't really... We can't really use the hunter's mark. Ammo left. We just have to keep an eye on that. Very important. Yeah, now that we are not marking, like the mana aspect is pretty much resolved. or the mana issue we had. Let's get the next quest on the go. Just starting out with the next zone. I mean, I think it's faster running in between, but the road is just safer. There's a lot of cats we'll have to deal with if you just, course off the main track or the main road. The graphics of this game actually seems pretty good, right? For a game that's like, dude, I don't even know, 20 years by now? How old is this game? Still looks pretty nice. I mean, is it 10 out of 10 graphics? No, it's not.
You got...
What's this? Ah, my brother's report. I told him to be sparing with the use of the king's name, but he didn't listen. No harm, I suppose, though it's sure to ruffle some feathers in the Senate. Not that those weren't some feathers that needed ruffling. Ah! Nonetheless, I guess that means that I should send my report onto Ironforge as well, but I must admit, I'm a bit behind. Bloody cold. I should have some work for you later, if you're interested. Ah! At last, the supplies from Hans! I was beginning to worry. We've had scarce word from Anvilmar ever since the Trogs overran the pass. Thanks for bringing this to me, adventurer, and please, make yourself comfortable. You must be tired after your journey. Beldin Steelgrill owns the local mechanic shop, and he's the best siege engine tech there is. But he's not forgiving to his tools. I swear he almost breaks more Arclight spanners than we can supply him with. We just filled his last order for tools. If you deliver it to him, I'm sure he'll make it worth the effort. His shop, Steel Grill's Depot, is just northeast of Carlos. And it's a local haunt for veteran siege engine pilots, so keep your ears open for opportunities while you're there.
Oof, the 25 crit though. Looking juicy. Very juicy indeed. I think I was sting mist or something, I'm not sure. There was no poison on that boar.
I'm preparing to start a mission for the Siege Brigade. It's a long one, and I need to stock Jetsteam with a month's worth of supplies. So while Steelgrill is working on my tank, can you do some hunting for me? I'll need some fur for bedding, and boar meat for food. You can get meat from boars and fur from the bears. You can find them both in the snowfield south of the Grizzled Den. Driving a siege engine isn't for everyone. It takes an iron grip and nerves of steel. Lucky I have both. How about you? How's your metal? Want to prove it to me? Well, I'm looking to make my engine, troll plow, a little more cozy. How about you get me a heap of Wendigal mains from the Grizzled Den, west of Clarence? Those mains would make a great boat for troll plows inside deck. Hegnar Rumbleshot sells guns off the road to Anvilmar. Rifleman and mortar teams spend a lot of time practicing out near his shop, and he's always needing fresh ammunition. But the last crate of ammo I sent him got lost along the way. My courier said he was camped near the Grizzled Den when Wendigo chased him away, and the fool left Rumbleshot's ammo behind. Adventurer, can you get that ammo and take it to Rumbleshot? He's been waiting on it, and I'm sure he's running low. You have my tools? Well done, lass, well done. I just broke my last fang ratchet an hour ago, and I need one of those to finish repairs on Pilot Stonegear's siege engine. You did a good thing by lugging those tools here, adventurer. Here, take these coins for your help.
Better give me those coins for help. I need it. Now that I talk about the gun, like, we must probably have to buy a better gun. Wendigo main. Slap it like it's hard. The hunter's mark on that one. Goodness. Running fairly loaded. We're three hunters here. Why free fall? Why did he change the loot to free fall? Why did he change the free fall? Idiot. easier. Unfair. We don't have to get free fall loot, dude. You get one, I get one. You get one, I get one. Then all is working fine. I got a bow, but obviously I can't use it. Oh, I got a gun upgrade. Nice. And a bag. Should I eat something? Are you done? Take it. Gonna pass on it. Are we just dead now? Yeah, we're just dead. I just pulled another one. Fuck's sakes, bro. Okay, I'm out of combat. I'm still out of combat. Fuck, am I dead also? If I'm dazed, I'm dead. Oh. Ooh. Oh my goodness. Bro, you can blame me all you want. There was nothing I could have done. I was on 2 health, dude. Oh my goodness. I survived. No. The mage caused the problems. I was on... I got out with 2 HP. Don't... So I had to sneeze there. Don't take the blame for something I didn't cause. I didn't cause the issue in the first place, right? It wasn't me bringing 7 enemies to the fucking, like, on top of others. It wasn't me. So why must I take the blame for someone surviving or not? If I didn't cause the problem in the first place. I thought I'm helping the mage, all of a sudden there's 4 of them, dude. And which 2 of them attacking me the whole time? Okay, this fucking place is done. I will not take the blame. No, I don't care what that guy says. There's nothing more I could have done in that situation to save someone else's life. If I did anything else, I would have died. And if I got away, right, and he was dazed. If I got out and I wasn't in a safe position to help someone, I would have done so. I would have got an aggro off him, for example. And I would have helped in some sort of way. See, the tigers will not aggro because they're not the same family. I honestly just can't believe we got out of it, dude. I honestly thought that's a sure death. Ah. Where's some bears, bro? You know, a lot of stuff like this is gonna happen in this game. Mistakes caused by someone else. And if you're the only survivor, then you're the one to blame. Because, hey, you could have done more. But this guy just instantly left the party. Had zero clue how much health I had. I saw, like, I hovered my mouse over him to look how much health does he have. So I walked as close as I could, not to aggro the Yeti, right? Because I had 2 HP, I couldn't take another hit. I stood as close to it as I possibly could. And don't pull aggro. While he had 120 health, refusing to walk forward. So at that moment, I knew there's one of two things is going to happen. Either both of us will die at the exact same spot. Either both of us are dead right here, right now. Or he must move forward. Like, I'm sorry, but if you run away from enemies, dude, I haven't played this game for so long, right? For more than a year, I haven't played World of Warcraft. And I remember the biggest thing to deal with enemies is to never run with your back towards them unless you're out of range to get auto-attacked. So he should have ran, jumped like I did, turning my, like, facing my front towards them so that you will not get dazed. Just by pressing forward and they hit you from behind, I think you have like a 30 or 20% chance or something to get dazed. And his cause of death is getting dazed. But the whole situation would have been better. Would have been better. If that mage wasn't running over us with 20 adds. So yet again, am I to blame? Like, honestly, no, dude. I shall not and I will not take responsibility for what happened there. It sucks when someone makes a mistake and someone else dies because of a mistake that they didn't even make, right? Sometimes it is what it is.
Hegnar Rumbleshot at your service. Great, more ammo. Old Loslaw's shipment finally came through.
Buy a bow?
Late, but just like my granddaddy used to tell me, late's better than never. Thank you much, adventurer. I already have buyers eager for this stuff.
Am I singing correctly? Okay, this item's actually not that bad. So it says buy a new gun, but our gun we picked up from the chest is actually good enough. We can maybe get something for this. I don't think we can though, we'll see.
Be good.
Do we need more boar? Crag boar rib. So it looks like it's a specific boar. Because again, this one doesn't show we're getting it. Also, by the way, if I died there, I wouldn't even whisper someone. I'd be like, fuck that shit, I'm out. Stop my video, make a new one. You know? Because like, it's still part one, but... it's just maybe a difference between us as well. This guy sat in the public chat room for 10 minutes complaining about something that I had no control over and like wants to blame me for being the sole survivor of the massacre and said that I sacrificed two dwarves. I... But yeah, we need to stop talking about that, bro. Like, I feel bad about it, but at the same time, I'm like, why should I even? What happened, happened. First of all, it's history. And second of all, it wasn't even me, dude. There we go, we are getting it from them. Even though it doesn't even say it. Now I actually want to upload my Hunter playthrough earlier. Just so that the... this guy can see what happened, if he's ever gonna watch the video. Okay, we got our meat.
My report and could use your help, adventurer. I just managed to find where the trolls are holed up, but I saw so many trolls, I was afraid to go in. Here's what I need. Go down to the cave, poke around inside, kill a few of the trolls, then come back here. Take the road north out of Karanos. When you get to the bridge, follow the frozen river west until you reach Iceflow Lake. You'll find Brunol village on the west bank. The hold is southwest of the village. Nothing my tavern patrons enjoy more than some beer basted boar ribs. Only problem is, the local trapper who used to bring me supplies enlisted in the King's army to help with the war on the Alliance front. Maybe you can help me out. If you bring me 6 crag boar ribs and a rhapsody malt from the tavern here, I'll give you the family recipe for my famous beer basted boar ribs, not to mention a free sample, the secrets in the malt. The malt is brewed, the boars are dead, and before all is done and anything said, we will have to fight for first dibs on these savory beer-basted boar ribs.
well.
By Magni's beard, you sure did a lot of hunting. Thank you, adventurer.
Ridge old Barley Brew experiments with his brews. Some of them taste good, some bad, and some, well, some will lay all but the stoutest dwarf flat. He lives at Brunol Village, west of Karanos, and one of his drinks, Evershine, is what I want. It'll help keep me warm while I'm on the cold road. And the blessed stuff burns so hot I can throw it in Jetsteam's furnace for a burst of power. That little tactic has gotten me out of more than one tight spot. Ah, yes, these mains will work great. You show a lot of grit, adventurer. I wager we'll see great things from you.
Upon further analysis of the Nomarigan situation, it would appear as though we not only failed to eradicate the Trogs, but we also happened to turn most of the gnomish race into horrific, mindless, evil-doing leper gnomes. Ozzy and I plan to reverse the horrible leper effect with our latest invention, the Recombobulator. The machine is almost complete, but we are in dire need of some restabilization cogs and gyromechanic gears. Retrieve some from the leper gnomes out front of Nomarigan for us.
I think we're going to go to Ironforge quickly and just train leatherworking and skinning.
Great to meet.
What do you need directions to?
Which class trainer might you be looking for?
What do you need directions to?
Which profession trainer would you be looking for?
The skinners usually take all their hides into Ironforge to dry out. Why don't you head there and see if you can find one to train you?
Do you guys see it? It's supposed to be a flag. No, there's no red flag here, man. I don't see no flag.
What do you need directions to?
Which profession trainer would you be looking for?
Skinning? The only thing you look like you could skin is your own knee! Ha! Now why don't you go see Balthus Stoneflayer so he can teach you how to properly skin some animals? You'll find him in Fine Spindle's leather goods on the northern side of the Great Forge.
Okay, it's not that far away. We got 15 silver to spend. He wants 10 gold for this piece of junk. 19 fire resistance.
To make leather. There has to be some way to cut down on all this waiting. It can't be good for my health, you know?
What else do we want to learn?
Do you need directions too?
Let's get first aid.
Which profession trainer would you be looking for?
A valuable skill first aid is. Our resident trainer, Nyssa Firestone, can show you how it's done. Look for her on the southern side of the Great Forge at the Iron Forge Physician.
We already have cooking.
What can I do?
The esteemed Dr. Gustav Van Housen can train you further. He can be found in Theramore treating the wounded at the barracks.
We want also to grab the flight point while we're here. Is there anything else we want?
The Wildhammer dwarves might have fast steeds, but can those airy peak griffins stand the heat of the Great Forge? I think not.
He joined a guild. Well, isn't a guild called Wipe Faster? It's a little scary. A very cool guy, that's his name, is looking for a very cool guild. Level 5 human paladin. Okay, we can check out the auction house as well. Maybe there's like a... I don't know. A bow... Oh, sorry, a gun upgrade or something. I don't think I should be wasting my money like this. But let's just have a look here. Requires level 8. I think. Okay, so we did all we could now. We got our first aid. We got our skinning. We get parried level 8, concussive shot also. So concussive shot is your slow. We get raptor strike 2. That's pretty big. Yeah, biggest thing is just, Asper the Hawk. The Hunter takes the Asper the Hawk, increasing range attack power by 20. So we get Asper the Hawk, and then we get Serpent Sting level 2, and we also get our beautiful head. Up until then, Hunters is useless. Useless. And obviously depending on the pet, but hunters become from most probably the weakest level 9 in the game to the strongest level 10 in the game, like literally in one go. Go. Also, I think you get better ammo than the ones we have. Thank you. A skinning knife does more damage than our main weapon. I shouldn't have done that. Because now we have to train the weapon. You need a weapon in your main hand. Okay. Put that axe back, dude. Okay, first aid. Leather working. Okay, the boars don't actually aggro. Oh, there's another dead body here. So we don't have to kill the boars, but I want to. We get food and we get skin, so we might as well. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, bro, please. Oh my fuck, dude. We missed him three times. Three swings. Three weapon swings in a row. We fucking missed him. That's a level 11 elite. That is what killed that mage that was laying on the floor.
I had a month's worth of dried meat salted and locked away for the cold season. Kept it locked so the bears wouldn't get it. But while I was off hunting deer, that beast, Old Icebeard, made off with the meat locker. He won't be able to smash through that thorium, though. But I'll starve if I can't get my meats back. You seem a bit more stealthy than me. Perhaps you can retrieve my stash. I'll never make it in and out of that cave fast enough with this bum leg of mine.
Okay. If I just saw the elite run back into the cave. Take up to 5 minutes, let him walk out. When he's out, loot the cave. There's anyway no way I'm gonna kill a level 11 elite, even if I had my pet. Even if I'm level 11, the elite would still like destroy our face, dude. Still inside. I'll wait here until he's gone. Okay, someone is coming to kill the elite. A level 11 hunter. I'll just help him because his pet is almost dead. His pet is dead. Okay, but so is the Yeti. So, whatever. I steal loot. You can kill him again. Okay, thank you. Just thank him and run.
A lot.
All right. Well, that works. You know, patience sometimes is a good thing. 11 guy coming here. Well, I think if it was anything else other than a hunter, it wouldn't have been done. And I think also if I didn't help him, there might have been a big problem.
What a kind soul you are, adventurer. Thanks to your bravery, I won't find myself starving when the cold season flurries blow in.
Okay, we're level 8. Now it says turn in that quest. Hour 42 minutes, goodness. Ooh, is this free loot? Free skinning? Yes, it is. Don't fail attempt, goodness. Quickly, before they despawn. Oi, listen to me. Just accept my dagger. Fail attempt on a bunny? On a rabbit? Gotta be kidding me, bro. Good news. Level 8 boar. The Skin Master.
You got
Bellow Fizz needs some of my Evershine. I have a cask of Evershine handy, but can you do me a favor? Brunel Village could use a hand against the wild animals that wander the nearby snows. Sometimes they wander close. We're not afraid of these bears and cats and boars. No self-respecting dwarf would be. But if you can take care of those animals for us, then we'd have more time for our crafting and brewing. I'm on a quest to make the perfect stout. I know I can do it. Brewing's in my blood. I just need to find the right recipe. The Frostmane Trolls grow a plant, Shimmerweed, high up in the hills to the east. They use it in their strange tribal rituals. We dwarves haven't found much use for it, but it has a unique taste. And I want to experiment with it in my brews. Get me some Shimmerweed from Frostmane Seers, or swipe it from the Trolls' Shimmerweed baskets.
I have to admit, those Thunder Brews make some good drinks. But they need to learn that theirs isn't the only decent brew. Maybe you can help me teach them that lesson. Here, take this barrel of barley brew scalder. Sneak into the basement of the Thunderbrew distillery in Karanos and switch it with one of their barrels of thunder ale. Then we'll see how their patrons like my brew over theirs. And if the barrels are guarded, then you might have to distract the guard.
Shows the waypoints. A favor of Evershine. Like, right now, it's not showing me the waypoints, bro. It does show it on the map. It's roughly there. 9 enemies. Oh shit. We have to run here. Because I think I pulled 2. Yeah. See, now the enemies have more than one ability. This one got Growl, which is just taunt. Claw and dash. The dash is movement speed. And then claw is an ability. If you're playing a druid, the claw would give you combo points, pretty much. Stop fucking dodging and missing, dude. Jesus. That is so annoying of this game. Like, I get there's a chance for it, but why does it have to happen almost fucking every attack, dude? And sometimes, like, even 3 or 4 hits in a row. Looks like we're gonna be here for a while. Getting boars, cats, and these humans. At the same time. Wow, we need the bears also. This is where it feels like the hunter is falling off a cliff, because you have to somewhat stutter step now in order to just survive. Oh fuck. We got spawn on top of. Oh, we got something. Attack power. Oh, dude, another bag. Is it soulbound? Doesn't look like it. I would actually want to send that to my warlock. To train swords, we have to go to the human zone, the Stormwind. Oh my god, bro. He crit me or something, and it just like took all my HP. Try again. They killed it, but didn't loot, so I can't skin. So yeah, those bears, I don't know, they are very tanky, and they hurt. So far we have better luck with the boars. We do have our aspect up. Yeah, this is where hunters feel so weak. Warriors is the same though. They feel so weak until you get like a new weapon. Or at least some green armor. We have a lot of leather. We can actually do something with it. There's a cat that runs up and down here the whole time. Very There it is. Oh, he's casting something. Strength. Reduce your strength by 2. It's a 5-minute debuff. The strength does affect our attack power in melee form with the hunter. It doesn't affect our gun damage though. And the crowd goes wild on our first gnome kill. I'm just kidding. Someone just reached level 60. We can also use this big tree as a form of defense, since we can shoot through it. So also maybe get well fed. Okay, we got the buff. Something like this. I love shooting gnomes in the back, bro. So satisfying. Looks like we can also use this. But we have a stronger thing here. Because they don't run through here. So we could just... do this. Thank you. playing the game on easy mode, dude. Who says you have to play hardcore on a hardcore? Now we got two of them. Does it matter? Are you cheating? Okay, let's get them grouped together. There we go. Oh, I didn't mean to shoot that guy. Another one spawned. Goodness, dude. They all respawned on us. Do you know what they say, right? I'm too sexy for that shirt. I don't know where, like, I think there's more that I can't see. Get it. Well, that was great. It was great. What do we get now? The cats. Ice bears, cats. Lots of skinning to do here. A rogue with skinning also. Two damage, four damage, miss, dodge, parry. Don't even ask me how a freaking cat is parrying you. Is he smiling when you hit its teeth or like... Okay guys, this video is 2 hours long, so we're gonna actually end it over here. We have loads of quests to do. Let's just make sure we log out safely. Actually, let's run a little bit closer here. Because it looks like that bear is walking very close to us. But yeah, we'll see if the series does well, we'll continue on from here. If part one does well. Otherwise, we'll just continue on playing other classes, and if not one of them does well, then we won't play World of Warcraft. So it's on your hands whether you continue on or not, or we just end it here. Hope you guys did enjoy today's video. If you did, leave a like, subscribe if you are new, and I'll catch you beautiful people in the very next video. Take care. Bye-bye.